Hi, it's Joanna Conde, and I shouldn't be smiling because this morning I got an email and I didn't take my own advice and I took the bait and I got caught in the middle of a scam. So I am putting this in front to say, show you that, even some of us who think we know what we're doing can get caught. If you listen to the end of the video, I'll tell you what happened, how it was resolved. But this is really important. Don't get scammed. Greetings. It's Joanna Conde again with AI for Seniors. And today I'm going to be talking about scams. Now, I'm going to show you how you can use chat to find out if you have a scam that's come through your email or any questions about scam. Now, if you don't have ChatGPT on your computer yet, you can go to the first in this series, ChatGPT Made Easy for Seniors. Get it up and then come back and listen to this video and follow along. So, today we're going to talk about scams. And the first thing we're going to do is how do you use chat and what questions should you ask it? And so, I'm going to share my screen. Okay. As you can see, I'm not a real pro at this, but I do have a passion for it. And I really think it's important that as seniors, we learn to go into new technology. And we learn things so that we can help ourselves and we don't get into trouble. So this is it. Here we are. What are the most common scams that target seniors? I think that's important to know. How can I tell if a phone call is a scam? What should I do to report a scam to authorities? These are all of the questions, and these are available. And if you would like a list of these, you can either copy it and paste it from here. Or you can email me, and the email will be posted on our YouTube site. But here, let's do what are the most common scams that target seniors? I'm going to copy, and I'm going to change my share, and I'm going to do in chat, and I'm going to paste it in. And now I'm going to ask it the question. But see how easy that was? And here it is, government impersonation. I don't have to read this to you because if you have chat, you can ask the question yourself. But there are a whole lot of questions you have. Here's another one. You think you have a phone call. How can you tell if a phone call is a scam? And here it is. I don't have to ask you that, but here's the important thing. Not only does it tell you if to do it, it tells you what you can do. Hang up immediately. Don't give any personal information. Report the call. And I could go into this. This is, if I clicked on this, I would get this another website. It tells you where to go. And then it said, would you like a short printable checklist for seniors for you to keep near the phone? You can ask that and it will say it to you personally. So here's another one that we can ask it. How do I get rid of robocalls? Okay, and then it gives you advice. If you do answer, that's it. Never press buttons like 1 or 9 to be, this is just confirms your number is active. I didn't know that. Never press buttons like 1, just hang up. Okay. Most smartphones have robocall blocking features. iPhone tells you what to go, how to go to it. Android. It tells you exactly what to do on your phone, step by step, so that you can get rid of robocalls. Isn't that cool? You can register your number with a National Dual Call Registry. The point is that you can get this information yourself. I don't have to read it to you. You can find it yourself. You can copy and paste. You can keep asking questions over and over. The nice thing about chat is it doesn't roll its eyes. It doesn't treat you like you're stupid. It doesn't know if you're really a senior or not unless you tell it. And it will answer the questions again and again and go deeper and deeper if you need it to. So anyway, and you don't have to be a perfect typist. And you can even use a microphone, except my voice is so bad that sometimes it doesn't understand what I'm saying. So I hope you can. But anyway, that's what we talked about today. Again, this is Chat AI. AI for Seniors. I focus on ChatGPT right now. My name is Joanna Conde. And if you like this series, please give us a thumbs up. and please follow us. Thank you.
Hi, it's Joanna Conde. Thank you for listening to the end. So what happened was this morning I got an email and it was early in the morning and I wasn't paying attention and I was just dumb. So let me share my screen and show you the email I got. Okay, so here it is. And these are the clues and I should have known what they were. One, it says PayPal up here. You have all of this. It's right here. It says no reply, no reply, 296, etc. And up here it says, hello, reply to, no, that's not it. I can make this a little bit bigger. Wait a second. So you can see it a little bit better. But this is it. These are the clues right here. This isn't it. No reply. Right there, you know. It comes down. It tells me what it says. How much money was here they were taking. It says, please call and or the number. Okay. So that's what it looked like. And now I'm going to stop my share. The warning signs were there and I didn't pay attention. I have no excuse. I am so angry with myself. It took a long time on the phone and they were getting into my computer because I was dumb enough to call. And then about 45 minutes in, after they'd gotten into my computer, were looking at things there and asking me questions, etc., Wells Fargo called and said, we had a mysterious thing from PayPal of $500. First time. Are you, you know, and they said, it was a scam. Are you on the phone with them right now? Yes. Get off. Hang up. Period. Which I did. And then they guided me through the steps I had to take. But I will tell you, it took all morning. I had to call BASC, which is the computer service company I use. They had to scan my computer. It was wasted time. And I could have really been taken if Wells Fargo hadn't been right on their toes. Dumb. So don't let it happen to you. If it happened to me, it can happen to you. Thank you for watching. And if you're still interested in this, please subscribe. We'll have hopefully more things that would be of interest. Thank you.